Hey everyone, I'm Snipezy and welcome to my new Let's Play of Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. This game is pretty good in my opinion. I've heard that a lot of people are not so happy about it because of the glitches and stuff like that, because it's just not a good game. But in my opinion, I think it's actually not too bad because like I enjoy the gameplay, it's pretty good. You know, it's not too bad. But anyways, let's get straight started with this.
It's all right. We give thanks for the blessed flames. May we always continue to have peace. Son of Soleanna, guide and watch over us with your eternal light.
Pleasure to meet you at last, Princess of Soleanna. I am Dr. Eggman. I've come here to obtain the secret of the Flames of Disaster from you, and to take the miracle gems that are the key to its secret, the Chaos Emerald. Now, Princess, this way, please.
Pretty snazzy performance there.
You? It can't be.
I'm Sonic. Sonic the Hedgehog.
Not that irritating hedgehog again! Attack!
I finally found him. The Iblis Trigger.
Alright, seems like there's a new enemy on our hands. And a mysterious hedgehog, for that matter.
Why are you helping me?
No special reason.
Sonic!
I'm afraid our little game ends now.
Sonic, take this!
I've got it! And don't worry, I'll rescue you!
I know.
It's only a matter of time before it's mine. Until then, you can hold on to it for me.
Alright, seems like we gotta rescue the princess. And we have to collect information about Dr. Eggman. And we're entering Soleanna. I think this is like the only Sonic game that's based off like the actual real world, I think. I mean, Station Square, yeah, that's based off the human world, but not a real place, so I don't know.
I need to gather some information.
Yeah.
If you see a mark above the head of someone in town, try talking to them. You may learn something important.
Yes. So, the person we need to talk to is somewhere. Oh, there you go. I saw a fox with two tails over by the plaza. It seemed like he was looking for you. Okay. And if you notice on a star, there's tails. Our trustworthy friend.
Sonic! Tails! Long time no see!
I'm glad you're here. I heard that you tried to save their princess from Dr. Eggman. You're going to rescue her, aren't you? Let me help. I may not know what Eggman's up to, but it can't be a good thing.
Okay, with your help, this should be a piece of cake.
I'll do my best.
Great, so we got Tails with us now. Got a bit of company. It's always good to have a trustworthy partner with us so they can help us out. Find out where Dr. Eggman's battleship went. Okay. I must say though, in this game the loading screens are far too long. I mean, it's taken us about 15 seconds to get this up now, and we just had a cutscene. Not good. So that's one reason why people don't like this game. I should probably do like a list of like, or like a countdown of reasons why people don't like this, you know, like this. Yes, but we need to do something first, so follow me, Tails. We need to talk to someone. Ah, I think it's you. My name is Alberto Robert, and I've been making shoes in this town for a very long time. I'm making the ultimate shoes now. These shoes use the power of Soleanna's mysterious stones to change. I'm calling them custom shoes, but there is no one that can test the full potential of these shoes. Is there anyone who can test the design of these shoes? You will be able to do that, really? Yes, we will. Because we want free shoes, we want to have them. Well, I mean, hopefully he'll give them to us. I mean, why not? But I don't think you want to smell Sonic's shoes, though, when he takes his off. That would be a bad idea. And those of you that have seen the Sonic Shorts episode, you'll know what I mean. Pull on the shoes and go for the rings. If I've made the shoes correctly, you'll make it on time. Alright. Okay, so we're loading up to this side quest thing, side mission, whatever you want to call it. There's quite a lot of these in these stories or episodes, whatever you want to call them, I'm going to call them stories for now. Alright, so we just got to go through these rings, very simple. Oh, sugar. What I do to get back my speed is just, like, do a homing attack. And then, I'm here. And then do a little circle. There you go. As well, it's quite hard to control Sonic in a way, I think. The controls with the characters isn't, like, smooth, I wouldn't say. It's quite wiggly. I don't know, the controls are weird. Amazing, they performed exactly as I thought. My custom shoes are complete. I will give you these shoes, you'll be able to use them. Money? I don't want any money. I'm happy just knowing that they're being used. The stones that you can fit into the shoes are called gems, and you can buy them at the shop over there. They're very rare, but if you put one in these custom shoes, they will give you an entire new ability. The best shoes in the world, worn by the best runner in the world. I'm so happy, thank you. Well, pleasure to be of service. So yes, he was right, we can get gems to power up our shoes. And the key to like getting the gems is basically progressing through the game and all that stuff. However, the only problem is that you have to spend quite a lot of money if you want all of these upgrades for Sonic. And by that I mean you would either have to get good ranks on the stages, or do a lot of side missions and try and get a good rank on them. If you don't, then you won't be able to use all of them, so bit of advice there. Anyway, so with the money.
You can shop in town. Go to the stores often to check out the new items.
Yeah. Hey. So welcome. And we can get the light chip. Allows you to use light dash by using the light dash. Okay, you can move quickly through a trail of rings. I thought it said you can use it or whatever. Like in the same context. But anyways, we're going to ignore that. We've got the light chip and we can use that to use a light speed dash or light dash, whatever.
When you get close to a trail of rings, press the X button to do a light
dash. Yes, thank you for telling us that, Tails, and it's just like that. But Tails died. Oh well.
This is the mirror of Soleanna. It will take you right to your destination with its magical power.
Yep, so we use these to travel to stages. Just hitting into the mirror there. So yeah, they're basically the portal to the stages, and we're entering Wave Ocean, and we have to pursue the egg carrier. And that's showing us some of the controls right there. So the homing attack, and the low kick or whatever, I don't know what to call it, but I guess it's low kick, or running kick. So you just have to press X when you're running.
I've got to hurry and save Elise!
Yep, we have to save Elise. And we're riding on the water! I think that's a pretty cool feature in this game. Alright, let's go for the rainbow ring! Awesome! I like the flow of, like, the running of the game, not the actual control of the characters, but sometimes the flow. I think it's pretty cool, to be honest. Like, most of the time, I guess. Like, when it gets to the good bits. But when not, it's a bit like, oh god.
Yep. If you jump just as you land on a wall, you can jump off.
Yes, we can. There we go. Oh, I missed a coin, doesn't matter. Wait, am I going in a circle? Oh, okay. Let's go for the ring.
Okay.
There we go. So, in grinding in this game, oh, I missed that. You'll notice that it's a bit different. Oh, I can't do that. Yeah, you'll notice it's a bit different because it's not just like hold down X to grind or anything along that line, because it's just weird in this game, I guess. But it's okay. It just helps you sustain speed and go faster.
Whoa, that's a big one.
But then they got rid of the speeding up railing, I think, after. Was it Sonic Unleashed or something like that? Oh, jump!
Jump!
This stage really reminds me of the first stage in Sonic Adventure when you're at the beach and there's the whale, you know, when you're running on the board.
Alright,
so now we're playing as Tails and we have to kind of help Sonic because he's stuck in a whale.
Press and hold the A button to fly. Be careful, you'll get tired if you press the X button to lay a dummy ring on. Button to perform a dummy ring snipe.
Yep. So the snipe isn't that amazing. It's if you want to hit something that's quite hard to aim at. So it's not entirely useful. But I like that when you're gliding or flying whatever, that you can just keep on tossing fake ring bombs or whatever.
Alright.
See that? That was pretty cool. Just take them all out. But the thing is though, Tails is quite a slow character, so I think the speeds of the games could have been adjusted in a way. I mean, the pacing and the speed of the game were a little bit off sometimes. See, when I mean like the good parts, that's just basically like when you're on the dash rails and when the game's sort of playing for you, but yeah. Doesn't mean it's a bad game though. And now we're heading into one of the best parts of Sonic stages, and you shall see in a moment when this loading screen actually loads.
Darn! We're not gonna make it! Let's speed up!
Yep, so, like, this is one of the first times where they made Sonic go even faster than what they've done in the past. I mean, that's a big achievement in my opinion. I mean, the games used to be very slow without this, if you think about it, because before this game, there were, I can't remember. Like, I don't know if the Wii games were after or before. I think they were before, right? But anyways, this game just shows that Sonic has reached a new speed that's even faster than what he went before, apparently. Pretty good feature though, if you ask me. And of course it's exclusive to Sonic and all else, unfortunately. But that's what makes Sonic so great. And we're going to run a little bit faster because we have to go around this loop. Oh, I'm not going to catch the... Okay, thanks. I know at one point, if you go too far off to the right, then you actually fall into the water and off the loop. So be careful of that. Right, so how well did we do? It's a good score, actually. An A. Yeah, that's good.
No sweat.
Not the best, but not the worst. But that's more like a B, so... So, overall, we did very good on that stage. And we got a Soleanna gold medal. They're just collectible because people like collecting things, I guess. I think that feature is very tedious to collect the gold medals in this game. I don't see the point in, apart from achievements, but no, not for me.
It looks like the princess was moved to another location. Let's head back to the city.
Good plan. Let's just run away from where they were going. And they were just there. Yeah. I know I'm noticing the flaws, but it doesn't put me off the game. I play what I feel, so yeah. I've got to make this game enjoyable somehow, right? I can just basically laugh off everything and be like, oh, that's a flaw, haha. Or you guys could just laugh at me when I have absolute rage things that things. Rage things that things. That completely makes sense, doesn't it? By that I mean. What do I mean by that? I can't remember anymore. My mind went blank. Right, where are we supposed to go now? Ah. Right, I need to talk to one of you. Hey, that kid's climbed all the way up there. What's she doing? So, if we talk to this person. Dr. Eggman, I don't have time for you right now. Please come back later. A little girl got up on a roof somehow and can't get down. Okay, so what we have to do is...
Yep. If you can squeeze through this gap, you'll be able to save the girl!
Wait, how do I... Hang on. Oh, no, I don't want to talk to you.
If you can squeeze through this gap, you'll be able to save the girl!
Yeah, I know. And I can't remember how. And Tails, what the heck are you doing? Right, see, this is another feature where I could rage. Right, I thought you were meant to... Hold up. Okay guys, it turns out that I actually need to get the upgrade. Anti-gravity allows you to use sliding. By sliding, you can attack enemies whilst moving. Okay. See, I thought that was a move that you got when you started the game. But anyways, just to show it off to you guys, just do it like this. So basically you just hold down X, or for me because I'm playing on 360. So now let's just head over to where the little girl is, above that thing. Oh, there she is. No! Where am I? Tails. Where are you going? Right. There we go. Follow me, Tails. Nice landing. For once. I'm sorry to make you worry, Sniff. I heard Eggman was going to the desert, so I just wanted to watch from the high place. But why are you crying about it? Why? This doesn't make sense. Oh dear. Oh well, but at least we know where the heck he is. He's headed towards the desert. Alright, and I don't know why that happened when I, when that kick happened. But anyways, quick, chat to you.
Hey.
Oh, you passed from Lord Regis, then there's no problem, go ahead. Alright. So let's head into the desert.
You're a good girl, Elise. Remember, be brave. Don't cry, no matter what happens.
Look at Tails.
Sonic.
Just call me Sonic. Now then, are you okay?
I'm so glad that you came.
I always keep my word.
Sonic!
Oh, rude.
It looks like a pesky rat has stuck its nose where it doesn't belong. Well, a hedgehog to be more precise. The princess is mine. Until I unlock the secret of the Plains of Disaster.
Tails!
Got it! Let's go!
Alright. So now we are going to be heading into a boss battle, just so you guys know.
I'll take care of you now. An early breakfast for my pet.
And that's like, I think Cerberus is like based off the mythological dog-like being. That was like a massive dog, I think. I know my knowledge, yo. Right.
This is your pet, huh? Okay, Eggman, I'll play with him.
Right, let's do this. So the way to take out this guy is. It's kind of simple, really, but it can be quite hard to actually take him out, say, as in to actually take over him. Yeah, so yeah, you basically have to make him run into something. So the quickest way I find is to hit him into the statues, because he takes a lot of damage if you hit him into them, and you can kind of try and see if you can grind on his tail by homing attack, because you know it kind of aims for his tail because it's like a rail technically. Right, we just gotta wait for him to come down, but avoid the attack at the same time. Right, so yeah, the best time to get him when he's weak is when, what the heck? What the heck was that? I have never seen that glitch by the walk, before, can I just say. How the heck did that happen? I am so confused right now, that just blew my mind. I just went up in the air like God took me away. That is just bonkers. Come here please. Good doggy. You need to tame this dog, he's wild. Right, Let's grind on his back. That sounds very wrong. Sorry that I said that. Right, let's make him hit into that statue. Alright. Yeah, I don't get that part when you can see his face. I don't know if he takes damage or whatever, but I just keep, you know, I just continue what I did before to say. Oh, I nearly had him. Right. Let's try and be careful this time around. Come on. Yeah, you can actually take this guy down in two hits because there's two statues. Right. Just need to try and get him to go there. But when he gets weaker, he'll actually turn away from somewhere where he'll actually take damage. Oh, we did it. Two hits. There we go. And we completed it in 1 minute and 20 seconds. Well, 19 seconds to be precise. Don't get technical.
I won't let you get away!
Too bad. Alright, we have finished this stage, and that's not worthy of an S, because I know this is that's quite a hard boss to get an S at. I think the key if you want to get an S is to try and do what I did, but collect rings at the same time, or do it a bit quicker. But apart from that, we got another pointless medal, but yeah, we'll just collect them because we like shiny things. Like if you remember from my previous Let's Play, we had lots of lovely emblems that were shiny and nice.
How long is this gonna go on?
Let's split up. I'll get their attention, and you take the princess.
Okay, you be careful, Tails.
Oh, the animation though. I think it's because of the, you know, those robots in the background, so it's making the whole thing slow down. Because it's, there's, you know, there's a lot going on to say.
Okay.
So they probably shouldn't have done that. Like, there, they didn't have to. They didn't have to slow down the animation just because of the robots. They could have just, you know, because they weren't showing. But anyways, now we're going to be playing a Sonic, but with Elise. So that's like, one of the unique modes in this game, and I think it's alright, it's bearable, I guess. I mean, there's a couple of these and they're not too hard.
Elise, hold on tight.
Yep.
Combine the two with the right trigger and use this new power to get rid of anything that blocks your path.
Yeah, so basically you can run over sand
if
like this.
Put your power together, you will be able to walk on this sand. But be careful.
Yeah.
Power is limited.
So as you can see in the bottom right hand corner, there's a bar there. So we can use that to use up the power of two or whatever. So that's got any springs. Attack you. And get this item box. Right, so which way do we go now? This way. Oh, we could go that way, but nah. Let's get this. Okay, we've got an extra life now. Good. Especially in this game, because there could be a lot of situations where you actually die a lot because of the glitches and stuff like that. You know, like what you just saw with that boss battle then. That was absolutely bizarre, may I just say. That was crazy. I never knew that something like that would happen on that boss battle. But you learn it. And they could have deducted that from my scoreboard as well. The game isn't that evil. Alright. I kind of wanted to go to the rings though, but we'll go this way, it doesn't matter. Okay, well done, mate. There we go. Get away from them. Oh, watch this, folks. I don't know if the power of two actually... yeah, it doesn't protect you. But you can use it when you're near enemies and they'll take damage. this. Alright, a bit of a shortcut this way. Well, actually a massive shortcut. Yeah, very nice. Take this thing with long arms out.
Whoa.
Oh no no, no 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 no. Please don't kill me. Please don't kill me. Please, please. Like, no, don't kill me. No, 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 no. This ain't happening right now. Okay, there's a spring up. Don't you dare. Right, let's try and make it safely. We can do this. That was just a silly fault there. Right. Back to where we were now. Jump on here, jump on here, and dash! I think as well, if you hit the robots in a certain direction, you can actually hit more than one, more than one robot. Just a ring here. But be careful, because those things actually fall and they can kill you. But anyways, we made it to the goal. We've achieved our goals, guys. We made it to the end. And another A. 3 A's in a row. Oops. Okay. I think these cutscenes are pretty impressive though. But there's only a few of them, which is kind of disappointing.
I have no words to express how grateful I am for your help. You're hurt.
It's nothing.
Don't say that.
Doesn't even look like anything to me.
I'm sorry. It's all my fault.
Smile.
Don't make me sass you.
Your smile. That's all I need.
Look at him strutting.
Eggman mentioned the flames of disaster. Is that why he's after you?
Yes. The name of the sun god our country honors is Solaris. It is told that Solaris's rage would destroy the world. His wrath comes in the form of the flames of disaster. 10 years ago, we almost faced the full force of his fury. I was a child then, so I don't remember it very well. I lost my father then. And now that man is trying to cause the same disaster again. What can I do? Sonic! Sonic! Wait! I can't run that fast!
Don't worry! Just raise your head and run! Great, doesn't it?
Yes. I've never run so fast before.
Nothing starts until you take action. If you have time to worry, then run.
Good advice, meaning that she can't really protect herself.
Whoa.
I've been looking for you. You're the Iblis Trigger. Your actions will condemn us all. Who are you? My name is Silver. For the future of the world, I will destroy you!
And there's the introduction of my favourite Sonic character in the history of the absolute franchise. I am obsessed with him. Not in
time
a creepy
for
way.
You to disappear.
I just think he's just so cool. I like the fact that he has like telekinesis powers and all that. Well, psychokinesis, sorry. But, you know, I think it's just so cool. It's just, that's like my kind of thing. Like, supernatural things going on, yo. I think he has cool powers. But anyways, we're going to fight Silver. Unfortunately, as much as I don't want to. Alright, so, try not to get too close to him. And I fell straight away. Right, yeah, try not to do what I just did then. Run away if you can. Try and get into, like... Alright, okay. It's fine. Try and get him to run into objects, because then he'll pick them up. So say like he's going to pick up... okay, maybe he's not going to pick up the table, but most of the time he will pick up things he's in front of, so... No, no! Oh, for God's sake. Right, Silver, don't make me hate you. I could never hate you.
Right.
Take that. So yeah, a good way to avoid his attacks is to like, run away from them or homing attack. But always try to keep your distance, otherwise he'll attack, he'll try to grab you. And when he grabs you, it's not nice, especially when you have no wings, because then he'll just kill you. And if you were homing attack him to actually damage him, then try and get away from him as far as, like, as quickly as you can, otherwise he'll be able to grab you within his reach, because he has quite a wide radius of grabbing you. But anyways, we did it. We defeated Silver, unfortunately. But we had to do it. And we actually got an S for that.
That was incredible!
Yep, I was right. I know this score's too much to know, like, when it's an S or not. I've played this game too much. But when I wasn't able to play it, I was like, oh my god, I have to play it. Like, in like 2009 or 2010, I was like, oh my god, I have to own this game. I have to.
Hey!
Ha! Oh, he's still got a bit of fight in him. Ooh, he took that hit. He's trembling.
Is this a joke? How could someone like you cause the destruction of our world?
What do you mean?
It doesn't matter. For the sake of the future, the Iblis trigger must be destroyed.
Elise? Wait!
Ha! Don't you dare turn your back on me!
Oh, you called him out there.
It's time I finally put an end to this!
Stop!
Amy? Get out of my way, Amy! This is my mission!
How to see Noah?
Absolutely not!
Thanks, Amy. I appreciate it.
Nothing is gonna stand between Amy or Sonic. Like, she would freaking die for him. Like, she'd die any day for him. Oh, God. Alright guys, thank you very much for joining me here, and thank you for joining me on the first part of Sonic the Hedgehog 2006. And I think next time I might start off the Silver story, because it is my favourite story personally, so... Yeah, I think I'll probably complete that first, then Sonic's story, and then probably Shadow's at the end. So, yeah. Anyway guys, thank you very much for watching. Please leave me a like if you enjoyed. Comment if you got any suggestions or advice or what you think of this game so far. Or what you want me to do in the future, let me know. And don't forget to subscribe to stay posted to this series and all my other videos, as I do post weekly videos every single week. So, until then guys, thank you very much once again, and bye for now.